Hey folks, it's me, Brian. I had beef stroganoff for dinner tonight, and what I'm drinking tonight is a monkey gland. This video will be one continuous take with no cuts, so let's get to it. I first want to talk about my liqueurs. Here's my berry liqueur. I've thoroughly enjoyed it. Oftentimes I have a little bit as my second drink of the night, just straight or on ice. Sometimes I've mixed it though. So I'm almost finished with it and I have to make some more. Now, if you remember from one of my other videos, I also made some mango liqueur. And here's the mango liqueur. I'm not even close to finishing it. I did not like it. I had it macerated in the grain alcohol for about a week. I think I should have had it in there a little bit longer. I've seen online upwards of about a month probably with the mango, but I haven't liked the mango as much as I've liked the berry liqueur. So tonight I'm going to have the monkey gland. It is an IBA specified cocktail. It's comprised of about an ounce and a half of London Dry gin. This is probably offensive to my big gin drinkers out there. Over the course of this year and learning about cocktails and trying different brands of rums and tequilas and whatnot, I've come to realize that I probably should take my game up just a notch and not get some of the rail or bottom shelf stuff. I was never a big gin drinker prior to this year, so when I went to get gin, I just got whatever. But I did up my game up with the Old Tom gin, and the next time I buy some London Dry gin, I will probably up my game some more. Oh, so it's an ounce and a half of the London Dry gin, an ounce and a half of orange juice. So I have the orange juice in this little container. I did not want the kids to drink the last of it, so I just put it in this container, in this bottle, so they wouldn't drink it. It also has grenadine. I have real grenadine. It has about a tablespoon of grenadine, ounce and a half of the orange juice, if I forgot to say that, a tablespoon of grenadine, and a tablespoon of absinthe. So I've used this absinthe before. I got a mini, partly because I didn't know, well, not partly, because I didn't know if I'd like it. I got two minis, but the recipes, the cocktails that I've made thus far that have had absinthe, I've just used like a dash or a couple drops, or I rinse the cocktail glass with it. This recipe will call for a whole tablespoon. So I have my tablespoon here for my absinthe and my grenadine. And then, like I said, I need an ounce and a half of the gin and an ounce and a half of the orange juice. So let's get to this drink. So already I'm missing something, but I'm gonna continue going because I know this, I'm missing my jigger. So I know this is an ounce. So I'll just use one of these and a half one of these to measure my ounce and a half. I mean, this bottle is plastic. What was I thinking? Right now, we're in the middle of a rain delay. Nationals were beating the Mets 5-3 before the skies open up. Mets did not look good tonight. Now on to my absinthe, Oregon Spirit. Tablespoon of this stuff, and I bet you it will overpower this drink. Oh boy, this is a lot. Now this is slightly green. I smell it from here. And real grenadine, a tablespoon. Shake and strain. And there you have it, a monkey gland. Prost, my friends. So this tastes like orange juice, licorice, and gin. That absinthe is so overpowering. I mean, I have more orange juice and gin than the absinthe. But that absinthe, that's, I can see why, like in a Cesaric drink and some other drinks, that you just rinse the glass with the absinthe, because it is so powerful. I would have to say this is an acquired taste. I have not acquired it yet, though. So I think I'll spend the rest of this video actually drinking it. Now, I did this on one other occasion with a beer, and I rambled for about a half hour. I'm not gonna keep you guys that long. Whew. Ooh. This is some strong stuff. This is some strong stuff, boy. Finished. Stay safe, stay sane, and I will see you tomorrow, folks.